Guys, are you able to hear me? Okay, good, good, good. Okay, some reason system got stuck, sir, so I have no other way, so I restarted the system. Now we are discussing actually administration console. Admission console. At the moment I am talking about these file level tables, whatever I am talking. These file level tables are called as Informatica tables. What I want to show from the database is, if you go to the database, okay, SQL plus, let us say, and if you connect to the system, let us say Scott at the rate of ORCL and Tiger. Now if you write in here select star from TAB tab, did you created this TAB tab, sir? TAB tab is a table, right? As long as TAB tab is a table name or not, first of all? So did you create that one? No, automatically it's created, right? That columns also, T name, tab type, whatever it is available, those all things we didn't create it. It is a system table. It is, sir? It is a system table. Similarly, whatever file 11 tables I shown, right? Those file 11 tables also Informatica system tables. What is that, sir? Informatica system tables. Those guys, advantage is whatever work down the line you are going to do, those all work is going to store in that file 11 tables. Those all work we are going to store in the file 11 tables. If you want to move from one development database to testing database, means this file 11 tables export you can take from the database and you can import into the testing also. Am I clear? Right. So moving this file 11 tables from one database to one data development database to testing database is nothing but you are moving Informatica work. You are moving what, sir? Informatica work. Yeah, good question. More than file 11 tables is available. Answer is, we have two types of repositories here down the line, you come to understand. Work repository and global repository. If you go for the global repository, another 10 tables will be added. Okay, so 521 will come. But 511 tables is the normal work repositories, 511 tables. Okay, come to understand down the line. Now, let us go for the, as part of first one. As part of first one, repository service is a storage location of Informatica source. Target, mapping, task, workflow, extra information are going to store it. Here we have the, how many tables are available, sir? 511 tables are available. Now we are going to create this 511 tables. We are going to create this 511 tables for our repository service. Shall we do it? Yes. As part of that one, step one is what, sir? Starting your Informatica server. Starting your Informatica server. Starting is very simple job. All you need to do is go to the start. Then all programs, control panel, administrative tools, services, select Informatica 9.0.1, right click, click on what, sir? Start. Shall we do the same job? Yes. I am going to the start. Next what, sir? Control panel. Next. Administrative tools. Next what, sir? Services. Already we are very well aware of this window. Why? Because we worked with the data sources ODBC when we were working with OVAWE. Yes or no, sir? When we were working with OVAWE tool, we learned about the data source ODBC. At that moment, we know this window. Now I am going to the services window. Then we got services window. If you see carefully, I have Informatica service. Informatica service, this is Informatica 9.0.1. In my case, already it is started, sir. Why it is already started is, I have here, it is what, sir? Automatic available. That means whenever my system is started, this also will be started. But however, due to performance issues and all, I recommend in our PCs, keep this as manual. Keep this as what, sir? Manual. How to keep this as manual, sir? Double click on the service. Here we have the startup mode that you can say as manual or automatic. Am I clear, sir? If you keep manual, whenever your system is started, it will not be starting. Okay, whenever you want to work in the Informatica, at that moment you can go and you can start it. At that moment you can go and you can start it. Am I clear, sir? In my case, I need not start it. That is already started, it is available. If you want to start simple, right click on this one, then start means start, you can do it. If you want to stop means you can stop it. If you want to restart means you can restart it. So I hope I completed the step one, whatever I defined here. Yes or no, sir? Starting Informatica server. Starting Informatica server. Second is Open Informatica Administrator homepage. Open Informatica Administrator homepage. That is very simple job. Start. Next what, sir? All programs, Informatica, then server, Informatica, Informatica Administrator homepage is available. Let us go and do this one. Start. Then what, sir? We have here Informatica 9.0.1, then server, then administrator home page, Informatica administrator home page. I am clicking on this one. At the time of installation, we given one username and one password for the Informatica, sir. That is administrator. In my case, I given password also we given as administrator. So that is the reason username and password provide as administrator, Username and password provide as administrator, That's what I am suggesting in the document. If you see here, provide username as what, sir? Administrator, password as administrator, then click on login. That's it. We are able to open the home page of the administration console. Once you open this one, next third step is what, sir? Creating repository schema in database. I said already, repository service is nothing but 511 tables, right? 511 tables are storing where, sir? In the database. In the database, if you need to store, means we require database on username and password or not? Database username password required or not, sir? Yes, it is required. One moment, sir. Guys, any old guys are there, please leave from the bridge, sir. Okay, right, sir. Now we understand our 511 tables are going to store in the database. So we require what, sir? One database username and one database password. In that process only I am trying to create one username and password. For that I am opening SQL plus. Next, what, sir? Type slash as sysdb. That means I am trying to connect to the database using admin user. Let us go and try to do that one. Already in my case, SQL plus is already open, right? Okay, I'm closing this one. Let us say exit, closed. Now I want to open SQL plus, means you can go for start, then what, sir? All programs, then what, sir? Your Oracle installation location, we can go application development. There I have what, sir? SQL plus. This is the one way of opening it. Another way of simple way of opening is go to the start, then what, sir? Run. In the run, you can write as SQL plus and enter. We'll get one window. In that window, you want to connect as an administrator, right? That is the reason I am giving as slash, yes, what, sir? sysdba. Advantage of this one is there is no password required, nothing is required. Directly, you will connect as a database administrator. However, in our real time, this may not be working. You need to have an administrator username and password. Like our system manager is available, right? System manager is what, sir? Admin user and password. In our training room, we can use slash as sysdba. No issue. I didn't disable this one. Am I clear? Right. Now, I would like to create one user. That is very simple job. If you see here, create a user by executing what, sir? Below commands. Create a user, itech info, identified by RRitech123. Some user I given here. You can create your own user and don't follow document as it is, sir. Why? Because if you see the itech info, in lab missions already I may be created. In my mission also already I created. Whenever you are doing your work, try to create your own thing. That means whatever name is available for that, prefix or postfix your name. Then automatically it will be unique. Am I clear, sir? Otherwise it will say as already this user is available like that. So in my case, I am trying to create one user. Let us create it. Create user. Yes, any one username I need to provide here. We are trying to store the repository, right? So I am giving your name as RRITEC. Okay, we are trying to store the repository. So I am giving as repository 003 I am giving. What I am giving, sir? RRITEC 003. That is what our batch number I am saying. Am I clear? Now, identified by create user RRITEC 003. Identified by one password we need to provide. Our password is what, sir? RR capital, next, itech small, 123. We can give any password, no issues. I am giving this password. Now, user got created successfully. Now, I need to create some tables, means create table permissions are required or not, sir? Required. So I can provide only create statement, those things. But however, in training room, I can provide all the permissions. That is the reason I am giving as grant DBA, database administrator permissions I am providing to this user. User is called as RR, iTech, then what, sir? Repository we are going to store here, 003. Okay, enter. Sorry. What is that? Oh, sorry. I am sorry. Grant DBA 2. 2 is missed out. Okay, you are correct, sir. Grant DBA 2, RR Attack, Rep 003, we provide that one. Now, I would like to connect to this user. How I can connect, sir? Connect, next, RR iTech Rep, then 003. What is the database name, sir? Your VRCL is database name. What is the password, sir? RR capital, then ITEC small, 123. Now, I am able to connect it. Now, once I connected, I would like to see any tables are available in this one or not. Select star from TAB. Do I have any tables are here? No rows are available. Just now we created our schema. The schema down the line is going to store what, sir? Informatica repository service file 11 tables is going to store it. That's the purpose I created this one. Am I clear? So that's what I'm trying to tell in the step 3. Creating repository schema in the database, open SQL plus, grant the permissions, connect, provide the password, confirm that one, there is no tables. Please note that no tables are available in the schema. Okay, now, next one is available, that is called as configuring repository service in where, sir? Admin console, very simple. Open Informatica administrator home page, provide username password as administrator, click on login. I hope already we logged in, right? This was the administrator home page, yes or no, sir? I need not do this first step once again. Already I logged in, yes or no, sir? Now what is saying, sir? Under domain navigator, select domain underscore RRITech. What is it, sir? Select domain underscore RRITech. If you see here, I have here domain underscore RRITech is available. In our case, what, sir? It may be something else. Your computer name is Mark. Then what will happen, sir? Domain underscore Mark may be coming. So while you are following the document, use bit of common sense also. Am I clear? So in my case, it is domain underscore RRITech. Go to action, new, click on Power Center repository service. Okay, provide below information saying. Let us go and do that one. I selected here domain underscore RRITech. Then action means what, sir? Here I have one action. Here also I have one action. Don't go this action. Immediately this action is available. Go here. Then go to the new. Then I have here Power Center repository services available. You need to click on that one. Power Center repository service. If I click on this Power Center repository service, then this is a two-step process. How many step process is? It is a two-step process. I have here only two steps are available. So first step is what, sir? Specify the properties for the new Power Center repository service. Properties are nothing but we need to provide a name for our repository service. Second is what, sir? A location for your repository service. Third is a license for your repository service. Fourth is a node for your repository service. These are the four informations you need to provide. Description is no star mark. That means what, sir? It is not the mandatory one. Let us go and provide it. I am providing your name also. RRITEC REP 003 I am providing. Sorry. RRITEC REP 003. Any name you can provide, sir. I am providing whatever schema name you provided, same name I am providing. There is no rule like same thing you need to provide. You can provide any name. Okay. To remember better, I am providing same thing. Synchronization I am doing. That's it. Okay. This repository is pointing to the schema. I can understand very quickly. That is the reason I am doing this one. Am I clear, sir? You can provide any name. Now, if you see a description, whatever you want to write, you can write it. This is a repository of OBAEE 185 batch batch students. Students, something I written. Now next one is, location. Location is automatically populated, sir. Location is nothing but your domain name. You need not touch that one, automatically it is there. Next, license is, at the time of installation, we provide one license file also. That will be available in the drop down. You need to select that one. Node also, at the time of installation it is created, that will be available in the drop down. You need to select it. So we provide information is, one is name, second is what, sir? Location, then our license, next node. These are the four informations we need to provide. That is our step one. Now, once it provides all things, click on next. Then it's going for the step 2 of 2. In step 2 of 2, what we are going to do? We are going to provide the information corresponding to what, sir? Database. In the step 3, we created here, did you see or not? What we created, sir? Schema we created, right? The schema information we are trying to provide here. The schema information we are trying to provide in the step 2. If you see in the screen here, what we are providing, sir? Oracle, INT info, like this I am providing. We completed step 1 and we are going to the step 2. Let us go and try to provide our own. Tell me, sir, database type. Your database type is Oracle or SQL Server or DB2? Oracle. Everyone need to interact. Oracle. Next, what, sir? Username is what, sir? RR. ITEC. Next, REP003. What is the password, sir? RR capital. Small I, small T, small E, small C, 1, 2, 3. Next, your connection string is, what is the connection string, sir? ORCL is your connection string, provide ORCL. Next, code page is available, it is nothing but your code page, sir. These are the code pages are available, Greek, Arabic, like this, language page. Whatever by default it is available, okay, leave that one. By default will come as a Latin, Latin will come, leave that one. Now, table space name also, don't give anything. We are not creating this one in one kind of table space. Okay, that's leave it. Now below this is one important option, sir, you need to understand. Specify the creation options for the new PowerCenter repository service. Content exists under specified connection string, don't create new content. No content exists under specified connection string, create new content. Tell me, we specified the connection is, this is what the connection we provided, right? RRITech003 provided. Under this one, do we have the already content is available? Content is not available, sir. Content is not available. Now tell me, you need to select first radio button and second radio button. Second radio button. That is good job. Second radio button. Previously I said work repository and global repository. I said, right? Here below, I have here create as a global repository. If I select this one, it is a global repository. If I want to maintain versions, means I can select this also. If you select these options, some tables will be increases. But if you select only this one, only 511 tables are going to create it. Only 511 tables are going to create. As of now, we'll go with the normal repository. Now, I selected this normal repository. I will discuss these things later point of time. Click on finish. Click on finish. If I click on finish, what it is going to happen is, it's trying to create here repository. Okay, it is creating. If you go back in and if you see, it's trying to create what, sir? 511 tables trying to create. Now see, a 207 came, 318 came, next what, sir? 381 came, next what, sir? Again 381, still it is creating. 406 came, next what, sir? 511 tables, this was the final one. This was the final number, 511 tables are created. That means if you create the repository service, what is creating backend, sir? 511 tables are creating, 511 tables are creating, that's it. Now, we created successfully our repository service, that is done. If you see here, I have so many repository services are available. RRITech 002 also available. And we have here BIA, RSA is available. So many things are available. However, I recommend in my training room, I am executing different batches. For each and every batch, I am creating one repository service. But in live, you'll have only one repository service in one project, sir. You won't have multiple repository services. Most of the times you'll have only one repository service. Okay, yours is very, very big project. Multiple teams are working on multiple things. At the moment, they may be create different repository service. But end of the day, we are going to integrate these all things into what, sir? Single area. always remember only one repository service will be available. Only one repository service will be available. Right. We understand how to create this one. How to create this one. That is completed. I want to walk through the step 4, sir. Let's see step 4. We open the administration console. Next one, sir. Under domain navigator, select domain RRI tag. Go to actions menu. Then what, sir? New. Next one, sir. Click on Power Center repository service. Provide below information. Name as what, sir? RRI tag underscore RS. In our case, I provide something else. Screen, I given something. Okay. RRI tag rep I given. Next, select license and node. License and node we need to select like this. Then provide below database information. Create in step 3. This is what the information whatever you are providing. Whatever you create in the step 3, those are things you are providing. Click on finish. Once process is completed, in SQL plus execute select count star from tab and notice that how many tables are available, sir? 511 tables are available. 511 tables are available. Now let us move on to the next one, that is called as changing operating mode from exclusive to normal. If you see here in our thing, I have here what, sir? Repository, but this repository properties operating mode is available as what, sir? Exclusive is available. If a repository mode is available exclusive, then we cannot move further. It should be available in the normal mode only. Why? Because this repository service, end of the day, it should be available for the integration service. I'll talk about integration service later point of time. Integration service is the one service. It is going to read the content of the repository service and is going to execute the content of the repository service. Integration service is what, sir? It uses the repository service. Integration service has to use this repository service means it must work in what mode, sir? Normal mode. So how to change that into the exclusive mode to normal mode, we need to understand. How to change from exclusive mode to normal mode, we need to understand. To understand that one, let us go and try to follow it. Very simple job, sir. Very simple job. If see here, I am going to the select RRI tag repository, click on repository properties, edit. Next one, sir. Change operating mode from exclusive to normal. Click on OK. Restart repository service by clicking on OK. Let us go and do that. I am selecting here edit. This is what the edit is available. Already I selected my repository. I am selecting here edit. Then we have here operating mode as exclusive. If you go for the drop down, I have what, sir? Normal. Then don't select any other options. Click on OK. That is asking restarting is required. So what do you want to do, sir? Click on OK. Again, it is asking complete you want to do, abort you want to do. Abort means immediately it is going to do it. Complete means what, sir? Anything is in between is available. Any processor available in middle, it will complete those things, then it will be stopping. Do you understand the difference between complete and abort, sir? Abort means immediate action. Abort means what, sir? Immediate action. Complete means what, sir? Anything is in between is available. Midway is available. It will wait for until the work is completed. Then it's trying to stop it. That's the difference. You got my point? Right. Down the line also this terminology is very important. Now I am saying as of now, just we only created this one, right? We know like nothing is in between. Yes or no, sir? Nothing is in between. That is the reason I am clicking on what, sir? Abort. Click on OK. Now automatically it's trying to restart, disabling the service. And due to the performance reasons also, I don't want to keep this many repository service in your laptop, sir. If you keep this many things in your laptop, your Informatica server will run for longer time. Okay, that is the reason keep one or two if you want. Okay, now normal mode I switched, the PowerCenter repository service is what, sir? Available. So I completed the step that is called as changing operating mode from exclusive to what, sir? Normal mode I completed. Next is what, sir? Creating integration service. That's what your steps, right? If you go and see your administration console, I give an admin activity server. So first is creating repository service. Second is what, sir? Creating integration service. Repository service we understand very well. Yes or no, sir? Now we are moving on to the integration service. Let us go and try to see that one. I am selecting your integration service. Integration service. Integration service are services are useful to read metadata. Metadata. This word is very important, sir. This word is very important. I said one word, if you remember or not, any data warehousing tool is going to work on the metadata. We are not going to work on what, sir? Data. In runtime, data will come into the picture. In runtime, data will come into the picture. As of now, we are going to work with the table structures and those things only. But not the values, not the values, not the data. It is going to read the metadata from repository service and execute corresponding workflows. Execute corresponding workflows. So whatever content available in the repository service, those all things is readed by the integration service, and down the line it is going to execute those things. Now we have your process. In the process, select our domain underscore RRATech. Go to action menu, click on new, click on Power Center integration service. This is same process or not, sir? Same process. Let us go and do it. I am selecting my domain. Then action menu, new, Power Center integration service. Click on that. Then I need to provide your name. This is also two-step process only, sir. This is also two-step process only. And these all parameters, whatever available, it is common for that one and this one. Yes or no, sir? First screen is common for repository service as well as integration service. Now, I want to give here one name. Any name you can provide. I am providing here RRITEC. I am providing here RRITEC. We are trying to create integration service, right? I am giving the name as what, sir? INT. And our batch is what, sir? 003. So, I am giving 003, let us say. Now, description is whatever you want to write, you can write it. Okay. It is useful to run. It is useful to run what, sir? It is useful to run. It is useful to run metadata of repository service RRITEC, what sir? REP next 003. It is useful to read and run metadata of repository service RRITEC REP 003. Now I am giving your location, that is automatically populated. Next is what, sir? License. We need to select the license as whatever available in the drop down, node also whatever available in the drop down. Okay, now click on the next. I am trying to click on next. It is asking step 2. Step 2 is what, sir? Specify the Power Center repository service you want to read it. I said one integration service is going to read one repository service, right? So let us go and try to map that one. Power Center repository service you need to map here. What do you want to map, sir? RRITech rep 003. And whenever you create one repository service, by default one user will be created. That user is called as administrator. So I am giving the username as administrator. This is the repository service username, sir, not the database. Now this repository service password also, what, sir? Administrator only give that one. These things we given at the time of installation. Now, data movement mode, ASCII is by default available. Two things are there, ASCII and Unicode. By default ASCII, leave that one and click on finish. Now, it is asking you want to go for the primary node. Click on OK. Now, it's trying to run it. It's saying as it is the Power Center integrated services, what, sir? Disabled. If it is came in the disabled mode, if you want to enable, in the corner I have one option that is called what, sir? Enable the server. If you click on this one, automatically it's trying to enable it. This Power Center integrated service is enabling. Now if you see carefully, the Power Center integrated service is what, sir? Available. If you have any problem in our repository service, if you have any problem, it won't be enabled, sir. Suppose previously we moved from exclusive to normal, we moved, right? If you didn't do that step, then it won't be coming as what, sir? Available position. It will be disabled position only. It's going to throw error. Any problem is there with your repository service, it's going to throw the error. Am I clear this point? Now, down the line also, if you want to understand this integration service is mapped with what is a repository service, then you have here what's the option? Associate repository. If you go and see what is the repository service is mapped, sir? This one. If you see here, let us say one more thing is available here, RRITech002. This is mapped with what, sir? If you go and see associate repository, that is something else. If you go and see our OBIA, BIA underscore IS is available. This is mapped with what is the associate repository, sir? BIA underscore IS. Here I have a lot of integration services, lot of repository services are available. And one more thing is, for one repository service, I can map a number of integration services also. For one repository service, I can map what, sir? A number of integration services. When we'll go for that is, only one integration service is not able to read all the things, execute all the things, performance is degrading. Then we'll try to add what, sir? One more integration service to improve the performance. If did you observe or not, whenever I am creating this integration service, I create one more thing if you want. Action, next what, sir? New integration service. I given some name here. I am selecting here some license, some node. If you click on next, I can select again what, sir? 003. That means for this integration service also, I can select the same repository or not, sir? That means for one repository, can you map n number of integration services? But when you will go for that one, sir? If you want to improve the performance. But in our training room, you do not go for the multiple integration services. One integration service is enough. Am I clear? As of now, I am trying to click on cancel. Please make note of this one. For one repository service, you can map what, sir? N number of integration services. For one repository service, we can map n number of integration services. N number of integration services. So let me walk through the nodes process. Select domain underscore RITech, go to action menu, new. We need to provide this all information. Then we are going for the associate repository we are selecting, and we are providing username, password and data movement mode we are providing. Click on what, sir? Finish. That is completed. Now, successfully you completed installation of the Informatica, and we completed creating what, sir? Repository service, creating integration service. These all three activities are one-time activities. These all three activities are what, sir? One-time activities. That day one, whenever you install your product, you need to do immediately these things. Okay. Daily, we won't do these all activities. Am I clear, sir? It is a one-time activity. That is one thing. And in the lab, seriously, don't delete any repository service, sir. Exclusively, here I have BIA underscore RS, BIA underscore IS, two things are available, right? Don't delete these two things. These two things are corresponding to my OBIA. These two things are corresponding to what, sir? My OBIA. Please don't delete those two things. If you want to practice delete option, you can practice other things. Okay, don't practice on this one. Okay, delete option is available here. Okay, you can delete it if you want. But these two things, don't delete it. Am I clear? Right. Okay, because if you delete that one, I need to do a lot of work again. Okay. Now let us go for the next one, next component. Next component is what, sir? Repository manager. This is our second component. Yes or no, sir? This is our second component. Now, in the repository manager is a Windows-based component. We already knows only one component web-based. That is what, sir? Administration console. Remaining all are what, sir? Windows-based only. Now, this repository manager is useful to do these activities. One is what, sir? Add a repositories to clients. Just now we create a repository, RRITech REP003, right? That one you want to add to your client or not, sir? Yes, you need to add it. How to add that one? You need to understand. Second is creating the folders. How to create the folders? You need to understand. Third one is deploying from one server to another server. So this repository manager is also help you to deploy from one server to another server. Okay, we'll try to understand those things. As of now, first point is what, sir? Adding repository to client. Let us go on to that one. Start all programs, Informatica, client, PowerCenter client, PowerCenter repository manager. Then what, sir? Click on OK. Shall we do this one? Step one, first step. Start, next. Next. Here I have what, sir? Repository manager is available. Click on that one. If you click on that one, we'll get one window. we'll get one window. We'll get one window. This window is called as Welcome to Power Center Repository Manager. Did you know? Each and every time it is going to give one tip, sir. It is going to give one tip. This is optional window only. If you don't want to see next time onwards, if you remove this one, next time onwards it won't come. But don't remove it. Keep that one. Okay. Click on what, sir? Okay. Now try to maximize this one. I maximized. As it is not opening using URL, it is called as Windows based client. Here I have previous batch things. RRATX002 is available. I want to add our repository, right? How to add that one? How to add that one? That is very simple job. Go to what, sir? Repository menu. Then add repository. Click on add repository. There is asking what is your repository name. What is your repository name, sir? RR. You can give small also, but as a best practice, always I'll use Captain. Okay. Visibility wise good. That is the only reason I am using. Even you can use a small also. RR I take. Next word, sir. REP003. What is the username, sir? Administrator. In administrator, A is capital. Remaining all are small. Administrator I am providing. Click on OK. Then automatically my repository is added here. Now I would like to connect to this repository. How I can connect it? Right click on this one. Then what, sir? I have your option called as connect. And we'll get one window. This is what the window what we are getting. Now, if you see here, first time if you are doing, let us say first time you are opening, sir. Just installation is completed. First time you are opening. In the drop down, we won't get this domain, sir. In the drop down, we won't get what, sir? The domain option. We need to add that one. First time you are doing means what, sir? We need to add that one. How to add is very simple. If I click on this add option, there will get one window. It is asking you what is your domain name, what is your gateway host, what is your gateway port number. From where I come to understand these three informations. From where I understand what is the gateway host, what is the gateway port, what is the domain name. From administrator page. Let us go for administrator page. What is your domain name, sir? Domain underscore RRATX. That means first box is done. Second is what, sir? Gateway host is asking. Which integration service you are using, sir? Go to that integration service first. This is the integration service you are going to use. Then, I am sorry. Which node you are using, sir? This is the node you are using. Go to that node. And if you select that node, right side, we are seeing what, sir? Host name. Host name is what, sir? RRITEC. What is the port number, sir? 6005. That's it. Now we require three informations. Three information is available or not, sir? The domain name is, this is what the domain name, and our host name is RRITEC, port number is 6005. We provide those all information and click on OK, our job is done. As of now, I am not doing that one. Why? Because already it is available here. If you see here, this is available. If you go and edit here, what is the domain name I given, sir? Domain underscore RRITEC. What is the host, gateway host I given, sir? RRITEC. What is the port number I given? 6005. This is what we need to do. So I am trying to click on OK. That is done. And we need to provide your password. Provide your what, sir? Password. Here, one important point I need to tell. Right click on this one. We are trying to connect it. Normally, what is our habit is from top to bottom, we used to fill it. Yes or no, sir? First we'll provide username. The next is what is available, sir? Password is available. I provide password. Then domain I need to select. I provide the domain name. However, connect option is what, sir? Disabled. Now I will do the same information in other words. I'll go for right click, connect. I won't provide the password. I'll provide what, sir? Domain name. Then I'll provide the password. Now connect option is what, sir? So the order of providing the information is important here. The order of providing the information is important. That's what I given very clearly in the document also. Right click and connect. First provide what, sir? Username. Then what, sir? Domain. Then password. Order is very important. Don't forget this one. Now we provide that one. Click on connect means it's going to connect it. I connected. Now as of now nothing is available inside this one. Yes or no, sir? Now let us go and try to create one folder. Let us go and create what, sir? One folder. How to create the folder is very simple job. If you go and see your notes, creating the folder, select your RRATech repository, go towards our folder menu, click on create, name it as RRATech, click on OK, again OK. Shall we do it? Now I am going to the selecting this one, go to the folder menu, create, our folder name is RRITEC, then click on OK. It's saying as the folder has been successfully created. The folder has been successfully created. Click on OK. Now RRITEC folder is created. With this we completed creating what, sir? Folder, creating folder. With this we completed that exercise. Next is what, sir? Configuring RRITEC database. As if people are aware of already, my training standards will be totally different from other people, right? Okay, if you see the OBI also, we are not going to use the data, whatever all are using it. Even Oracle guy, whatever he is using also, that data I am not using. Oracle guy used to explain that one using BI sample. But I used to use my separate data, yes or no, sir? Similarly, in Informatica course also, I am not going to use regular employee table, DP table informations. Okay, all our other people may be using that EMP and DPT. I don't want to comment about it. Okay, in my case, I am going to use my own data. That is the reason I created my own database. I created those database how to install into your database. You need to understand whatever data I created, the data how to install into your database. You need to understand. For that one, I am creating your databases. Your database means we require for Informatica two databases. We require, right, sir? One is what, sir? OLTP database. Second is what, sir? OLAP database. At least you require OLTP transactional data tables, you require analytical data tables, you require. Now I am going to create transactional data tables in one schema, analytical data tables in another schema. Am I clear, sir? But however, in real time, for OLTP purpose, separate database will be there. OLAP purpose, what, sir? Separate database is there. But in my case, I don't have two databases. Inside the single database, I am maintaining one schema for transactional data, another schema for analytical data I am maintaining. Am I clear? Let us go and try to create that one. Very simple job, sir. Nothing much job. We know already how to create a user in the database. Yes or no, sir? How to create a user in the database? You know or not, sir? We are creating a user, SDBU. SDB stands for source database user. Source database user. That means my source data is available here. Now, how to create is OpenSQL plus /HDB, already we know it. Create a user with the name of what, sir? SDBU, grant DBA, this is some spell mistake. This is SDBU. Okay, connect to this one and password you need to provide it. Next, select count star from tab, we won't have any tables. Now, I am trying to go to RRATech lab copy, lab data folder and take full path of driver and execute as per below, we need to execute it. Then what is going to happen, sir? All the tables are going to create it. Let's go and see it one by one. First step is what, sir? Open SQL plus, type as a /SSDBA. Already my SQL plus is available. Can I switch that one, sir? CONN connect. Next what, sir? /SSDBA. Now connected. Now I want to create the user. Let us go for creating the user. Create user. For better visibility, I would like to write in capital letter. Create user. What is the name you are following, sir? SDBU, source database user. All it might be available. That is the reason I am post fixing with the 003 or bash number. Am I clear? Now identified by what, sir? RR capital, ITEC small, 123. RR capital, ITEC small, 123. Then I am trying to execute it. User created successfully. Then one more thing I want to create, right? I need to provide the permissions, right? Grant, next what, sir? DBA, next 2. What is the user, sir? SDBU 003. Enter. I want to connect it. How to connect, sir? Connect SDBU 003 at the rate of ORCL RR capital I take small 123 enter. Yeah, all caps I given. Okay. connect, what sir? SDBU, sorry. SDBU, next 003, next at the rate of ORCL, next all capital, RR capital, ITEC small 123. Okay. I read it as small, but I type it as capital only. That's what I have it in. Okay. Now it is connected, sir. It is connected. Let us go and see any tables are available in this one or not. Let us go and see select star from TAB. Okay, enter. Do I have any table, sir? No, just now we created. Now I want to create a source database. For that, what is my notes, sir? If you see this third point, go to RRI Tech lab copy lab data folder. Okay, RRI Tech lab copy lab data folder. If you see here in my case, Informatica master lab copy lab data, here I have what, sir? Source.sql. Next, what, sir? Target.sql is available. What is there inside the source.sql? Double click on it. What is there is, I have one table I am creating that is called as customer, and I have my own customized data is available. This all is what, sir? My transactional data. And I am creating one more table also. That is what, sir? Employee. This all data is my transactional data. And I have one more table. Vendor I am creating. This is what my transactional data. Product also available. This is all transactional data. Next is what, sir? Invoice. Invoice will be always is a bigger table, right? So we have a lot of data I have. Next is line item. Line item also bigger table. We have a lot of data is available. So what I am trying to do is, I am executing this means what, sir? Some tables I am creating. Inside that tables, I am trying to insert some data. Yes or no, sir? Inside that tables, I am trying to insert some data I am trying to insert. This total is I am calling it as transactional data. This is my transactional data. This transactional data I want to convert into the analytical data down the line. You got my point? Now I want to execute this one. And one more point, while you are giving the path here, don't keep any spaces in the path, sir. If spaces are available, then it is going to throw the error. That is the reason only normally I don't have a habit of creating here underscores and all. But wanted like created here underscores. Normally I used to give 03 space, lab space data I used to give. But wanted like created here what, sir? Underscore, because I want to execute this one. Am I clear, sir? Spaces are available, it won't accept. I am taking this path, control C, go to here, then before this one we need to provide what, sir? At the rate of symbol, then try to provide the path, paste it, then what is the file name, sir? Source.sql. SQL. Okay, enter. Now what is it doing, sir? It is creating the tables and creating the rows, it is modifying the tables, all the things it is done. Once it is completed, safe side, commit also give it, sir. What is that? Commit also give it, commit. Commit is completed. Safe side, give what, sir? Commit. Now let us go and see what is there inside this one now. Select star from TAB. Now we have what, sir? These are the six tables are available. Customer, employee, invoice, line item, product, vendor, six tables are available. Data is there or not, if you want to understand, select star from vendor. Now, do I have the data or not, sir? Data also properly created. That means, we done with our transactional data. This one, real time, we are not going to create any transactional data, sir. Transactional data already is available. Yes or no, sir? In our training room only, we are creating the transactional data. In real time, are you going to create the transactional data? No, transactional data is already available in the database. All we need to know is, the database name is what, username is what, password name is what, we need to know that one, that's it. You are not going to create the transactional data. Am I clear? Right. Now, I completed this one, right? Next is what, sir? Creating target database. I want target database also I require. Exactly. If you want to use a normal employee table, DP table, if you want to use as a source, then you need not create this one. If you want to use normally EMP table, DP table, whatever available, if you want to use that as your source, then you need not create this one. But I don't want to play with the 14 records. Okay, that is what my main goal. You are not going to implement actual scenarios of the Informatica. Okay, people are explaining like filter means filtering dbit number is equal to 10. What is this? To filter that one, I can write the SQL itself, right? So to implement actual scenarios, I went for my own data events, sir. Am I clear? Yes? Okay. Now I am going for the creating target database. Target database name I given as what's a TDBU, that stands for target database user. Target database user. Now let us go for same process. Open SQL plus, login as sysdba and try to provide the username and password and try to provide here grant permissions, everything. Am I clear? Let us go and try to do that one. I am going to the connect slash as sysdba connected. Now I want to create the user. Already I typed previously, right? Why can't I can utilize that one? This is what is available, right? What all I need to modify, sir, here? Instead of S, I need to keep what, sir? T. But normally I don't like this caps letters in the password. So that is the reason I am trying to delete this ITEC as what, sir? Small I, small T, small E, small C. ITEC. Is it correct? I am trying to enter. User created. Next is what, sir? Grant these permissions. Okay, grant also we have already. Grant DB, what I need to modify, sir? T I need to modify. Now grant. Grant also completed. Next is what, sir? Connect. CONN connect. Next. What, sir? TDBU 003 at the rate of varcl. Enter. Then RR capital ITEC small 123. Enter. Connected. Password is case sensitive, sir. Remaining all things are not case sensitive. Password is case sensitive. Remaining all things are what, sir? Not case sensitive. Now I connected. Do I have any tables inside this one, sir? Select star from TAB. Do I have any tables? No. Now I want to create the tables which are available in my target script. If you go and see here in the target script, what is available is, I am trying to drop it. Already if it is available, we are trying to drop it. Now I am trying to create some tables, aggregate tables, some fact tables, some dimension tables. Data warehouse means what, sir? It is a combination of dimension tables and fact tables, right? Some aggregate tables also may be there. So this dimension tables, this ODS. ODS means your staging area is available, right? Staging area, one thing I shown. Staging area tables I am calling it as your ODS. ODS stands for operational data source. Okay, staging area, I am calling it as what, sir? ODS. So, ODS tables, and we have some other dimension tables also available. If you go and see here, DIM customer, next what, sir? DIM representative, DIM vendor, DIM invoice, DIM time, like that, a number of tables are available. But no table, insert statement is not available, sir. We are not inserting data here. We are creating only what, sir? Empty structures. Data modeling. That means for my project, for my reporting project, what are the dimension tables are required? What are the fact tables are required? Those things I am creating here. You got my point? Data we are going to insert here using what tool, sir? Our Informatica tool. Only structure we are creating. You got my point? Now let us close this notepad and try to execute it. Control C. At the rate. Right click. Then go on edit. Paste it. And provide here, what is the thing, sir? Target dot SQL. Enter. Tables are created. Safe side here, we have some alter statements are available, if you see at the end, some alter statements are available. Alter statement is a DML or DDL, sir? Alter statement is a DML or DDL? Okay, that require commit or not, sir? Commit is not required. Alter. Okay, let us go and do that. Safe side, do it, sir. Okay. Commit. Commit is completed. Now we done with what, sir? Database setups are completed. In real time also, target database sometimes you need to create, sir. as ETL people, sometimes you have the creating permissions are there, you need to create sometimes. But sometimes target database also already available. You understand my meaning? Sometimes target database is already available, sometimes you may need to create it. Suppose initially I given on data modeling, down the line you require an aggregate table. For aggregate table, again, you cannot call the data modeling team, right? Okay, you can create that aggregate table. Okay, right. So we completed now creating the source database as well as target database successfully. Next is what, sir? Hands-on one, source and target import. That means now we are entering into the Informatica, sir. Now we are entering into the Informatica. Right, let us go for the next slide. I'm going to the learner level. Okay, introduction is already completed. Next is what, sir? Design and execution process. Design and execution process. Very, very important slide, sir. And very, very interesting slide also. Design and execution process. Design and execution process. Okay. If you say Informatica on the scale of 10, on the scale of 10, if you know these 6 steps, I can give rating as 4, sir. That means 40% of the syllabus you already knows if you know these 6 steps. You understand my mean to tell? If you know these 6 steps, whatever I am going to explain, I can rate it as, you know, 40% of the Informatica. You know 40% of the Informatica. That must have important these 6 steps. And the 6 steps will not leave you throughout the Informatica. Whatever you want to do in Informatica, you need to do these are the sequence of 6 steps. Like our, in case of our OBW, if you want to do anything, if let us have a table, if you want to use and you want to develop the report, means what you need to do, sir? You need to add into the physical layer, then BMM layer, then presentation layer, then you need to go for it. That 3 steps are not going to leave you. Yes or no, sir? Similarly, if you want to do any activity in our Informatica, these are the 6 steps you need to follow it. These are the 6 steps you need to follow it. Am I clear? Now, first step. First step is what, sir? Create source definitions. Where you are creating, sir? Not in the database. In the repository service. In Informatica repository service, you are going to create it. Where you are creating it? In Informatica repository service, you are going to create it. Create target definitions. Where you are creating, sir? In the Informatica repository service. Next is creating mapping with transformations. That means I want to convert one type of data into another type. Next is creating task, workflow and running the workflow. These are the steps available. We'll concentrate on the first one that is called as what, sir? Source. Source object definitions, we'll go for it. Feeling angry? Okay. We'll complete this source definitions, then we'll go for the break. What do you say? Is it okay? Right. Source object definitions. By the end of this section, you will be familiar with the design interface, and also familiar with the source types, what are the source types are available, and be able to create source definitions and understand source definition properties, what are the properties are available for the source. Able to use the data preview option, how to see the data from the Informatica. First point is, let us go and see next slide, see the method of analyzing the source. I can import the source from where, sir? From relational database. Relational database means, example, Oracle database, or SQL Server database, okay, or Teradata database, or any other things. That is relational database. You can import from the flat file also. Previously, Ramdas asked one question, did you remember or not? From mainframe is directly contacting, sir, that's what he's asking. Oh, no, we won't contact directly mainframe. Mainframe guys are going to provide data, they'll extract and they'll provide as a one file. That file we are going to use input to the our Informatica. That is flat file. You may have some XML object, that means what, sir, some XML file is available. The XML file also you can use as a input. So mainly 3 types of source are available. One is what, sir? Relational database. Second is what, sir? Flat file. Third is what, sir? XML object. And if you want to create manually also, you can create the source. How to create the manually, come to understand down the line. Am I clear? Right. Now, we are going to import the source information using one tool. The tool is what, sir? Source analyzer. Source analyzer. In the source analyzer, once you imported anything, okay, this information is coming and storing in one area. That area is what, sir? Repository. Through some protocols, TCP/IP protocols, it is coming and storing in repository. That means what, sir? Our 511 tables, whatever available, in that one it is storing it. Our 511 tables, whatever available, in that one it is storing it. Okay. Now, let us go for the next one. If you see here, if I want to import from the relational DB source, I said already we are going to import from three sources. I'm showing here the next screen is what, sir? How to import from relational database. I'm showing here how to import from relational database. Now, relational database source may contain what, sir? A table. It may contain what, sir? A view. It may contain what, sir? A synonym. You may have some other things also. Anything, if you want to import from database, you need to contact database, means we require one mediator. That mediator is what, sir? ODBC connection. ODBC connection. Open database connectivity. My Informatica source analyzer need to contact the database, means I require in between what, sir? ODBC connection. ODBC connection. Using this ODBC connection, I am able to contact the table. And I am going to take only what, sir? Definitions. Definitions means what, sir? Table name is what? Column name is what? Data type is what? Size is what? This is all the information. I am not going to take the data. I am not going to take the data. Only definitions. And the definitions I am going to store finally. Where I am going to store, sir? Repository. Definitions means, can I call it as metadata, sir? Metadata. That means metadata only we are going to store in the repository. Metadata only we are going to store in the repository. Now let's try to do this part. For to do this part, I have your notes also very clearly. Let us go and try to do it. Hands on one, source and target import. In this exercise, what is our understanding, sir? The exercise in this lab are designed to walk the student through the process of creating what, sir? Source target definitions by importing metadata from a relational database tables. Exercise 1 is importing source schema. This exercise walks the students through the process of creating source definitions from which table, sir? Employee table. Employee table is the one table which we created previously. Yes or no, sir? If you see our lab data source, we have one other table. The table is what, sir? Employee table. This employee table definition we are trying to import it. Am I clear? Right. Let us go and try to do that one. Start the Power Center designer. What is the first step, sir? Start the Power Center designer. So you are a developer. That is the reason we are going for what, sir? Designer. For that, very simple. Start programs, Informatica, client, Power Center client, Power Center designer. Let us go and do it. Even any one client is opened means, if any one client is opened, shortcuts are available here, sir. If you want to go for the designer, you can use what, sir? D, workflow manager. You can go for workflow manager. Monitor means monitor. What is the advantage of if you go for the designer directly from here means, already connected with the repository and also opened the folder, right? You need not provide again username and password. You need not open the folder. That is what the advantage of the shortcut. If you go from start all programs means, again, you need to connect to your repository and you need to provide your username and password, everything. Am I clear? Right. I'm going for, as of now, starting, right? That is the reason going from beginning only. Power Center Designer. Click on OK. Maximize it. Now, which repository you want to connect, sir? (003). Connect it. I'm providing password as what, sir? Administrator password as administrator. Click on connect. Now I connected. I want to open this folder, right? Open the folder means don't expand the plus symbol, sir. That is not the open. Opening means you need to right click on this one. Click on open. That is the open. Or you can double click on this one. That is also open. But if you expand plus symbol like this, it is not a open. Am I clear? Now I am trying to right click and I am trying to click on open. If you open automatically, this work area is going to change here. Is it changed or not, sir? It's changed. Now we opened the designer. That is fine. if you carefully observe this work area sometime, carefully observe this work area sometime, this is called as what, sir? Menu bar. It is called as what, sir? Menu bar. Whatever it is available, this total is called as what, sir? Toolbar. This is called as toolbar. This is called as what, sir? Navigator, or you can say repository navigator. What navigator, sir? We are trying to navigate repositories, right? That is the reason it is called as repository navigator. That is the reason if you see one shortcut is available, that is called as navigator shortcut. This is okay, going and coming. That name is not displaying. Yeah. Now see it. What is it, sir? Navigator window or not, sir? Even if you want to close this navigator window, you can go here, navigator, and you can open this navigator. This navigator is what navigator, sir? Repository navigator. And at the bottom, we have one thing that is called as, we can observe all our logs. If you save something, the save information you can observe here. And any notifications are there, the notifications you can observe. One of the notification, what we got, sir, now? Repository service notifications are enabled. Whenever you connect to the repository, automatically says all the things are enabled. You got my point? This window is as one name. That name is output window. What is it, sir? Output window. If I go for the view menu, there I have output. Output is going. Again, output. Output is coming. Yes or no, sir? And the main work area is, let us say I am closing as of now, navigator window, output window. What is this one, sir? This is called as main work area. This is called as main work area. Normally, window will be looks like this. This area is called as main work area. This is called as main work area. Here we are going to work here. Okay. Now how many parts are available, sir? Menu bar, toolbar, repository navigator, output window, next work area. And this work areas are, five types of work areas are available, sir. How many types of work areas? Five types of work areas are available. One of the work area, what is the name you are seeing here, sir? Source analyzer, because we selected this button. Second is available here. That is what, sir? Target. And also notice here, I am showing here source analyzer, right? There is a reason in the menu bar also, what is available, sir? Source. If I select here target designer, then automatically my menu bar is dynamically changing or not, sir? Changing. If I select here next one, that is called as transformation developer, it is changing or not, sir? Similarly, I have next one, maplet designer, it is changing or not, sir? Similarly, I have mapping designer, it is changing or not, sir? Changing. As of now, we are working with the source, right? Our aim is to work with the source, so I am going to the source analyzer. Am I clear? Yes, sir, are you with me? Hello? T-shirt. Line T-shirt. Okay. Now, if you see here carefully in the repository, I have here sources, but inside the sources, do I have any information, sir? Empty folder. After few minutes, we are going to see what, sir? Our employee table, we are going to see over there. Am I clear? For that, first click on source analyzer. I clicked on that. Then go and see your notes. This is what the window we got. Okay, and we connected to the repository. That all it is done. Then we are directly we are going to the importing what, sir? Source definition. For that, go to the select sources menu. Then what, sir? Import from database. So this is what the sources menu available. The sources menu will appear only if you select what, sir, here? Source analyzer. Otherwise, it won't appear. If you select here transformation something here, you are searching for sources means it won't appear. You got my point? Now I am selecting source analyzer. Go to the sources menu. Import from database. Click on that. Whenever you click on that, we got one thing, import tables window we got. In that window, I am seeing ODBC data source. ODBC data source. Here we have the so many ODBC data sources are available. B183 batch, B182 batch, this B180 batch, B171, everything is there. But our thing is available, sir. 002 also available. But 003 is available, sir. No. We need to create one ODBC connection or not, sir. How to create it? If you see your diagram also, in the diagram, if you want to contact the database using your source analyzer means this is our source analyzer, right? If you want to contact, what do you require, sir? ODBC. Let us go and try to create ODBC. Here we have the one, three dots are available. Click on that three dots. Then we got one window that is called as ODBC data source administrator window. There I have one thing that is called as system DSN, system DSN, system data source name. Click on add. Then what is the database you want to contact, sir? Oracle database. So select Oracle database. corresponding driver. Select Oracle database corresponding driver. Click on finish. Then we got one thing, data source name. Data source name is what, sir? Any name you can provide. Any name you can provide. Our understanding purpose, what we are going to connect backend. SDBU 003 we are going to connect, right? Yes or no, sir? SDBU 003 we are going to connect. So I am giving the same name for our understanding purpose. I am giving what, sir? Same ODBC name. If you want to add it, if you add it, ODBC also can add it. But I am connecting using SDB 003 schema. So I am giving the name also what, sir? SDB 003 name. Is it any problem? No. Now I am going for my TNS name. TNS name is available in the drop down. Select it. And my username is what, sir? With what user you want to connect to the database? Your source table is available where, sir? In SDB 003. So I am connecting with the SDB 003. And here click on test connection. What is your password, sir? I hope all capital you given, right? RR cap, RRIT is capital. 1, 2, 3, I give. Whatever you given over there, you need to select it. Connection is successful. Click on OK. Next, click on OK. Now, we go and select here. SDB 03 is available somewhere. Above that one, it is available. Select it. What is your username, sir? SDBU. SDBU 003 and owner name is available, right? Don't type any owner name. Okay, automatically populates. Use from keyboard tab button. Tab automatically is populating. And go for the password. Password is what, sir? RRITEC 123. I am providing connect. Now what it is going to do is it's contacting the database and whatever tables are available in that one, everything will be available here. Yes or no? Everything is available here. Now if you go and see what is the table you want to import as for your exercise. Only employee as for your exercise you want to import. Select that one. If you want to go for multiple things, you can use control button and you can select multiple things. As of now, I want to go with the employee. Click on OK. That employee is came here. Whenever our employees came to the work area, automatically you can see under source node, we got what, sir? SDB 003 or ODBC connection. And we got here employee table. Am I clear? Now, if you want to save this one, whatever work we did, that work you want to save it, go to the repository menu, click on what, sir? Save. Once you click on the save, you can see the running commentary here. Repository RRITech rep 003 in the folder RRITech. What has happened, sir? SDB 003 employees inserted. SDB 03 employees inserted. With this, we completed one job. That job is whatever I am showing in the PowerPoint. In the database, I have one table. The table I contacted using ODBC connection. I imported and I stored into where, sir? Repository I stored. I stored into the repository. Am I clear? This is whatever exercise one in the document. Importing the source definition, we provide all the information whatever you require as per your things. Okay. Then we are selecting employee table and this came in the work area and we are seeing in the employee table here. Employee table here. Next is if you want to observe the properties of this one. Properties means what, sir? Suppose someone is imported this one. If you want to understand what are the properties, double click on this one. Then you can go and see what from where it is coming, sir. From Oracle database it is coming. This is one of the property. This is one of the property. And what are the columns are available? You can see from these all things columns. What is the data types? What is the precision? What is the scale? Which is the primary key? These all are different properties of the source or not, sir? Those all properties you can observe here. You can observe here. And let us say if you want to write some comment lines for the previous people, whoever is coming down the line, then those guys need to understand means you can write some comment lines also. Okay. It is a table of CRM application Sybil. CRM application called as Sybil. Whatever you want to write it, you can write in the comment. So that down the line, anyone is seeing this one, you come to understand from where it is coming. Am I clear, sir? Comment lines you can write. Click on OK. It's a best practice purpose only, sir. This is not the mandatory. Wherever you see the description, it is a best practice only. And if you want to see the data, whatever available, from here only you can right click here. We have option called as what, sir? preview data, click on preview data, and we need to select your connection properly. Your connection is what, sir? HDB003, and your username is HDB003, password is RRITEC123. Now we are able to see the data or not, sir? This is what the preview. Did you understand whatever I outlined here? Those are things, sir. End of this one, we are coming to understand, be familiar with the designer interface. Yes or no, sir? This is what your designer interface. This is called as designer window. In the designer window, what is available? This window is what? This window is what? This window is what? Menu bar, toolbar, everything. You understand or not, sir? Yes. Second one. Second one is what, sir? Be familiar with the source types. We have source types is what, sir? Relational database, plot file. Next what, sir? XML definitions. You can create manually also source. Next, be able to create source definition. We are able to create or not, sir? Yes. Understand source definition properties. We saw what are the columns available, what primary keys, what those all things. Then be able to use the data preview option. Just now we saw the data preview also. These are the five things what you understand. That is clear. With this we completed the exercise one, and we are trying to move on to the next one, that is called as what, sir? Exercise two. Exercise two is what, sir? Importing target schema. Importing target schema. Okay, right. This is very simple job, sir. It won't take more than 2 minutes of job. More than 2 minutes. Why? Because already we know the source. Then target is what, sir? Similar process or not, sir? Similar process. Only thing is, previously employee table is available in HDB003 schema. Now my target table ODS underscore employee is available where, sir? In TDBU003 schema. Same steps of the process. Shall you do it? If you want target to import, means where I need to go, sir? Warehouse designer, it is also known as target designer. This is what the window. Target designer is also called as what, sir? Warehouse. Normally, ETL tool is for the creating data warehouse only, right? In our ETL tool, target means what, sir? Data warehouse. That is the reason some people used to say target designer as a warehouse designer. Don't confuse target designer and warehouse designer. Both are one and same. Am I clear? Even in the lower versions like 7.1, those versions, this target designer is called as warehouse only. Here the name also comes as a warehouse designer. Okay, right. Now target designer, then go to where, sir? Targets menu. You can guide me. Yes, please guide me, sir. Targets menu, then import from database. Next, I want one separate connection, right? Click on three dots. Everyone need to. System DSN, add, what is the driver, sir? Oracle driver. And I need to provide here connectivity accordingly. I am providing TDBU003. Then I need to select here ORCL TDBU003 test connection. Password as what, sir? RR capital ITEC small 123. Connection successful. Okay. Okay. And if you go and see here bottom of this one, we have here TDBU003. And TDB003, then this is what, sir? Password RR capital ITEC small 123. Now click on connect. Click on connect. Then TDB003 came. All the tables whatever available, it is came. In that one, what you need to select, sir? ODS underscore employee selected. Click on OK. That is came into the work area. Once it is came into the work area, you can see here one more node is came out, sir. Targets inside that one, what, sir? ODS employee. If I want to save this work into our repository, you need to go for repository menu. Click on what, sir? Save it. Now it's saying as repository folder RRITech SDB003 employee updated. ODS underscore employee is what, sir? Inserted. Why it is updated, sir? Tell me. I changed the description, right? I changed the description. After saving all, I changed the description. That is the reason it is updated. You got my point? Now this is inserted. This is inserted. Now we completed how to import the source and how to import the target. We'll see the PowerPoint also. In the sources plot file also is available, sir. Down the line we'll discuss it. Target object definitions. End of this one, what you need to understand, sir? We are able to familiar with this one or not, see it, sir. Be familiar with what, sir? Target definition types. Know the supported methods of creating target definitions. Understand individual target definition properties. Let us go and see it. This was the target whatever available. Okay. creating target automatically from source. From the source also you can drag and drop these things. I will explain in your later point of time. Okay. Now you understand how to import the target into the work area. Yes or no, sir? If you want to walk through your notes also, you can walk through it. Step one is open the warehouse designer. We opened. We provide all the things which is required. Then we provided here TDBU is the your connectivity name. Then we imported ODS underscore employee. ODS underscore employee is available in the work area. Now go to the save it, saving the repository, then automatically save it. And shortcut also available. The shortcut is what, sir? Control plus S is the shortcut. Control plus S is the shortcut. Okay. Next one is what, sir? Hands on to creating mapping. Hands on to creating mapping. Have a good breakfast. After the breakfast, we are going to discuss these things. Am I clear? Are you enjoying?
Yes.
Yes. Good. Energy I want.